Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video, we are going to build a dice game application using React.js. So you can see if user click on roll dice, so you can see this value is getting changed, and we are getting some score here also. So 4 and 3. So after adding, we are getting this heaven. Likewise, we are getting the 10 score because on both dice we have the 5. Okay, so this dice we are going to build dice with the help of Hunt Awesome. So you can go to the official website there and you can search that with dice. So you can get. You will get this Hunt Awesome icon. So this FA dice 2. So you can also put 3 or 5. Based upon that, the value of dot will get changed. Okay. So this 2 will be basically a dynamic for us. Okay. So and we will be also using a Hunt Awesome. Hidden in our React applications. Okay, so let's jump into the VS Code and start building this little dice game. Okay, so as you can see, I have already created a application, a basic React application using npx create React app and app name. Okay, so we have to do that one. Okay, so this is the basic React application. Okay, so first we will inject the Hunt Awesome hidden here. So you have to go to the this URL. Okay, and you have to select the first one, copy link tag. Okay, and come over here in public index.html and just paste it here. Now the Hunt Awesome is available in our application to use. Okay, now we will having a component folder. Okay, so in components we will have some files. Okay, so I will create those file first. So first we will have a dice css and dice.js. Then we will have roll dice.css and roll dice.js. Okay. So let's first start with the die component. Okay, so and we will import the our dice css file as well, die.css. And const die return and we have to use that Hunt Awesome icon. So class name, so this die component we will be using in roll die component, and from roll dice component we will be passing the props here. So the props will be as a prop, that will be the face, because this face will be a dynamic, so it can be 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Okay, so this will be a dynamic, this part only. Okay, so So we'll be using like FAL, FA dial, and this will be a face, okay? Now we have created this basic dial for default dial. Now come to roll dice component and we'll import die from die. Okay, and we will be also import the CSS file, okay. CSS. So let's first render the dice, okay. So die and the face we can give like 1, okay. Export default roll dice and just remove this one. We don't need this. Sorry. So we will be importing the roll dice component here. So the component is imported in app.js file. So let's see whether we are able to see some. As of now, it's very fast. So we will be applying some styling here. So I will add another class here, like die. Okay, and I'll come back to our my CSS folder. Sorry, file. Okay, so I will give font size 10 AM. So let's see whether we are getting some size changing or not. Okay, now the size is changing, and here you can also do this way. So just for demo, you can also do like 2, 3, 4. So as you can see, this face is a dynamic. Okay, the face value is dynamic. Okay, so we only need the 2 dice. Okay, as of now. Okay, so now let's give some padding. We will do an animation at last, okay. So let's give some padding and color green. Okay, now we are getting our dice, okay. So this component we have completed almost. Later we will add the animation. So we need to add the class name, okay. Now come to this component. Here we have to write all the logic of dice, okay. So use state we'll have some initial state. So die 1. Die 2. So these are the default value we are giving. After rolling, only the value will get changed. Okay, and we will having a rolling state, which is initially will be false, and we will be having a total score. So the total score will be as of now 4, because the value of die 1 and die 2 are 1 and 3, and after adding 1 and 3 it will become 4. Okay, so that's why the initial value of total score will is 4. You can give any value. Okay, so now let's come to the return. So I will not remove this one. Okay, I will add some class name here. Class name. Okay, roll dice. This is a class name. And there will be another class name. So roll dice container, and inside this I will put this two dice, and we will having a button. So button we will having on click, roll, and this button will be disabled when the rolling is to true. Okay, now we will be the value of button will be the conditionally. After clicking it will be same like rolling, and after 1 second it will become like roll dice. Okay, so we need to take here using the ternary operator. So rolling, and roll dice. Okay, and below button we will be having a total score. Total score. Okay, now first we need to destructure this all state value. So sorry, this will be a dice. Okay, not it will be die, not dice. Rolling and total score. Okay, so the basic stuff we have did here. Now we have to provide some default props here. Okay, so in functional component we provide default props like roll dice default prop. This way we provide the default prop in the functional components sides. And here we will be having 1 and the corresponding value 1. Okay, four, five, six, and you can destructure this props here. Size. Okay. So let's write this role handler. Okay. Event const role so this role event basically we have a two dice okay so we'll be giving like new die one and sides and we will be picking some random value floor and math dot random and side dot length. The same thing will be goes for the second die. Okay, so there is no change and this will basically return a random value and based on that we will be accessing the index of height. So this will return either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 something and it will access this index, array index. Okay, so since we are using here array of objects, so we need also a score. So we can use like score one equal to object dot values. Okay, and new die one. The same thing will go for the second die as well. So score. Now here you will be receiving something like this value. So you will be get either 3 or 4. Okay, like this value you will get. Okay, now with the help of this we will be able to add the score because the index will be always a 0 in this case. Okay, so we can add the this true value. Okay, so we can set the state. Okay, so die one. Now here we will be using the keys because it only accepts the keys. I mean this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this will be a dynamic. So we have to use the key here. Okay, so the key. So we can access the key like this way. And rolling will be true here and the total score will be like so. This all the you will always get zero index. At zero index you will have your the corresponding value. So you can do something like this: score 1 0, score 2 0. Okay, now we will wait 1 second, then we will set the rolling to false. So we can do set timeout here. Set state, so it will take previous state. We don't want to lose basically state here while setting the value of rolling false. Okay, and we will wait 1 second. So I am providing 1000 millisecond here. Now in the dice we need to, so here we need to basically convert this the die value into a string, okay, die one and die two. Okay, so because here if the value will be something like this, okay, like 1, okay, so something like in this format we will be having a value, okay, but the component is expecting a string here, okay, so we will be providing the string value here. Okay, so we can do something like this. So the string and die one, okay, the same thing will be goes for this one also, string die two, okay, and we need to pass the rolling state, okay, so we need to pass the rolling state. So we will be using rolling state to basically animate the dice, okay, we will be doing later, okay. So just let's see whether we have got any error or not. So we have got some error here, just set timeout, okay, so let's see. Error, okay, so what error we are getting? Okay, so we are getting an issue here. Okay, so let's see. So you can see we are getting the score value as well, and so it is working, but the animation part is not working because we haven't write the CSS styling for the animation of dice and the button. So let's do that thing now. So first we will be, so here we will be receiving one more props like rolling. So I will be destructuring rolling here, and I will be use rolling state here. So if rolling, then if rolling is there, then we'll have to add one class that is called shaking. Okay, now add this class here in the style file. So shaking, so we'll be using animation name, so this will be a bubble, so we'll be using the keyframe here, and animation duration will be 1 second. Okay, now keyframe we'll be using, now from transform translate 3D 0 0 0, and not 2, 50%. Transform, translate 3D, minus 25%. Rotate 3D, 0, minus 5 degree. Okay, I will copy this one because we need couple of time. Okay, so this another will be a 30, and then 45, and then 60, and then 75. And at the end, this will be 2. Transform. So this will be 20%, and this will be a 3 degree. This will be a minus 15%, and this will be minus 3 degree, and again this will be a 10%. So this will be minus 5%, and this will be minus 1 degree. So let's see whether our animation works or not. Now, so animation is working. Now we have to style this button component. So come to that role.css file. Okay, so first we have role.js. So display flex flow column no wrap and min height 100 view height. Now the second we have like roll dice container. So this will be a display flex, justify content center, align and center. Now we need to target the button. So we can target the button this way. And here we will be styling the button center width 15 mm, padding 1.5 mm, font size 1 mm, border 0 pixel. To remove the border, then border radius to give some curve around the button, color white, so the text color of button will be white, but background color will be like orchid, and margin top be 3 mm. Okay, so we need to change the color of button while hovering. So roll dice button hover background color will be dark slate blue. The cursor will be a pointer. Okay, so let's see. Okay, some styling got disturbed here. So this will be a line content, okay, not item. So let's see. So this align item, not that it's align as help. Okay, so let's see. Now we have did all the things, styling and animation part. So we have completed this little role life game in a React application. Okay, so I hope you enjoy this video, and if you like this video, then please subscribe this channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye bye.